Rube, just how would you define a Rube Goldberg invention?
Well, I've been called the father of automation. It's one thing after another. I mean, that's really the thing. And it's an illogical bunch of things which are put in a logical sequence.
Rube Goldberg.
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 I made a Rube Goldberg machine.
A Rube Goldberg machine, it's an intentionally delightful waste of time and energy.
Here's a typical example of what I mean.
Failures and two successes, but that's my hypothesis.
The internet, and YouTube in particular, has given a whole new life to Rube Goldberg.
Watch close. How does this work? It's just very simple.
Oh, and there it goes.
I suppose there are one or two among you who think that my inventions are a bit ahead of their time. All right, go on and say it. Downright screwy.
Doing something simple in a very complicated way that is not necessary. It's a goofy, gadgety, glorious sight to behold.
This bill is a bit of a Rube Goldberg contraption. Sloppy staff work right from the beginning, especially on this bill.
And this is the world's slowest Rube Goldberg.
Build Rube Goldberg machines.
Oh, no kidding.
I love it. You actually know what it is. I'm pretty surprised.
Absolutely.
Goldberg machine? Who built it?
Me. It made my hand, but I'm upside down, so I can't really help.
Yes, sir. Long, long after you and I have departed from this earthly scene, this machine of mine will be working on and on and on and on and on.
Oh my gosh, that is so fun.
Never get tired of it.
Absolutely. That is a perfect introduction to our finals live stream today. We have come to the end of the digital Rube Goldberg machine Minecraft competition. That is a mouthful for 2022. And we're so excited to unveil the winners today. Let's start with some quick round robin of introductions. My name is Claire LeBeau, and I'm the Director of Communications at NASA, the North America Scholastic Esports Federation. We use esports and Minecraft to help kids learn all kinds of things. And in this case, they learn a ton of engineering. So let's go around the circle. Eric, how about you next?
Oh, I never get to go next. This is great.
So hi, I'm Eric Leitner. I'm a STEM and computer science instructional facilitator for Broward County Public Schools. I am a global Minecraft mentor, and I am the advisor on all things Minecraft for NACEF. And I'm so very happy to be here. This is my favorite moment because we get to sit here and enjoy and revel in the wonders that have been built by the students who submitted these projects. I love it. And I'm going to pass it to Kathy because we're going to save Jen for the end here, I think.
Mm-hmm. The best for last. So I'm Kathy Chow Isaacs. Hi, everyone. I am a global Minecraft mentor, and I'm also part of the fantastic team on NACEF that brings you these Minecraft challenges. This is a great, great day that we get to reveal the craftsmanship for Minecraft and the ingenuity of these builds. We're really excited to share these with you. And with that, the reason that we're all here, right? Jennifer?
I am Jennifer George, and the reason I'm here at all is because Rube Goldberg was my grandfather. So his crazy DNA courses through my veins. I run the Rube Goldberg Institute for Creativity and Innovation. It's actually Innovation and Creativity, but of course I mixed it up. And we are so excited to be here with you guys today to show off the amazing work you did. It's so exciting for me because, you know, we can build Rube Goldberg machines in the real world, but in Minecraft, what we're trying to have happen is create these chain reactions, obviously in this digital landscape, but we hope that they react to gravity in the same way, and the laws of physics and engineering. And of course, because our focus is on STEM and arts education, we are hoping to see exciting narratives that come from the books that you guys were tasked to open this year. And how you illuminate them. So with that in mind, I'm going to pass it right back to Claire. And we're going to see, we're going to hear about the prizes you guys are winning and see what you guys did.
Oh, everyone always loves to hear about prizes, right?
Yeah, a little bit.
Just a little bit. So before we review what the prizes are, I wanted to take just a second and let you know about a new program that NACEF is creating with our partners at Tallow. Tallow is an application that is used for students to build a portfolio that shows their interests, their strengths, and then they can use that when they apply to different colleges, and different employers also are using that application to recruit and to find students who match up to their list of requirements. And this will be the first opportunity that we have for students in NACEF to add a badge to their digital profile. So you can go onto Tallow, you create your own digital profile, and then when you're describing your strengths and your interests, you will be able to add a badge. And if you look closely, these first three are all for participating in this digital Rube Goldberg competition. So if you're a participant, a finalist, or a winner, we have three different badges that are available for you to add. And that will be a way for you to let recruiters and employers know you're good at things that we just described: design, engineering, teamwork, technology, your creative person. So this is a fun new way that we've added for you to be able to showcase the fact that you're a participant and a winner. So we can't wait to see all those profiles created and see what you have to show there. So with that, let's move on. Besides the digital badging that you get, there are some pretty awesome prizes that are available as well within this program. We actually ended up adding a new category as we were reviewing the submissions because we saw some things that we thought were really good and we didn't have them identified yet. So we've created a couple of new categories for technical achievement and best last step. So we'll identify those as we go through, and you'll know exactly which submissions get those prizes. And winners in those categories are going to get, actually everybody who is a winner that we mentioned here, they're all going to get a certificate for participating in this event. And we're going to showcase all of that awesome work on the NASEF website and the social media channels. So this is your moment in the sun. Make sure that when you see that come across your social platforms that you share those out and show your friends and family, look, I'm famous. I got my video on NASEF. So we're looking forward to that. So within this technical achievement or best last step category, in addition to those two things, teams will also win a $100 Amazon gift card. So woo, congratulations in advance for that. That is the same prizing that third place will win in the junior division and the senior division. So they'll get those certificates, their work showcased, and the $100 Amazon gift card. Second place, you might imagine, steps it up a bit, and each team receives the certificates and getting their work showcased and a $225 Amazon gift card. So congratulations there. And then first place in the junior division, the senior division, and the at-home division, each team will receive the certificates being showcased and admission to the Rube Goldberg traditional contest and, yes, Amazon gift card, this one in the amount of $450. Wow. So you all are going to be so excited when you see your names on screen because, one, you're getting those awesome prizes, but two, how cool to have your work recognized and your creations recognized. So without further ado, I'm going to turn it over to my three colleagues here, and they're going to walk us through some of these winners.
All right. I'm excited. I'm super excited. This is the best part. We actually get to watch the videos. And this is great because normally we're trying to talk and play and stuff on the screen at the same time, and it's chaos. Not that we don't love chaos. We love chaos. But now we kind of get to sit back and we get to see the chaos that you've created, right? So this is, we get to be the viewers. So even though we're on screen, we get to be the viewers.
But wait, did you mention, where did the entries come from? Did you mention that?
I think I may have skipped over that. We had entries from 18 different countries this year.
What?
18 countries. That's so phenomenal. Cool. That's exciting. Phenomenal. Yeah. Thank you.
That was important. We can't leave that out. That's huge, yep. Right? And we're going global. We're going to go more global. That number's going to be bigger next year. I know it. We're ready to get started, I think, with watching some videos. And we're going to start with the whole point of this challenge, which was to open and illuminate a book with your machine. And we wanted to recognize one particular entry that really just figured out what that was supposed to be, right? They opened a book. That book opens beautifully. It has everything to do with their narrative and their theme that they created, which was around space aliens. And so when it opens up and it's kind of like a 3D pop-up book, you go, oh, I know exactly what's going on. Like, they nailed that last step. And that last step was so crucial that even if it wasn't one of our overall winners, it was important to acknowledge that last step. So
this is the winner of the
best final step.
Yes. Best final step winner. And this goes to, are we doing drum rolls or anything?
Oh, yeah.
It goes to Team Crazy Aliens with the best final step. So let's go ahead and play that video. We're going to jump ahead,
hello,
and we're going to see that last step right there. So let's watch those last few trees. Seconds.
Maybe it's magical, but it doesn't matter anymore because the alien team helped us open this book, and that's where we'll end the story. Thank you. Bye.
Ta-da!
Yay!
Right? And it's perfect because not only did they open the book, they included more steps than we even shared how to do on the stream. They had it better animated. It opened up. There's this beautiful build inside of the aliens that pop up out of the book. Like, it was just kind of perfectly put together. And we watched a lot of these videos. We had a lot of entries. And some books, you know, some teams used the in-game book. And again, that meets the challenge. We get it. Some tried and, you know, to animate, and it was really clever to see some of the ways they did it. But this one, like, it was just like, that's what we wanted to see.
It was
see
this great, kind of
perfect, yeah, pop-up book.
And
awesome.
Where were they from? Can you tell us when you...
I don't have that in front of me. All right, Kathy is on it.
I'm on it.
Kathy is always the investigator. That's correct.
Right. Well, I'm not very good at multitasking, but just curious.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm willing to go search. All right, hold on.
So while Kathy is searching, The next two awards, and we're going to do one for the junior division and one for the senior division, was to acknowledge two teams that did a really fantastic job with the technicality of their build, as in it really represented what a Rube Goldberg machine was supposed to be. They did a perfect job of creating steps. Those steps linked together beautifully. There's a clear visual of the course that everything is sort of taking and manipulating, and we can perfectly see how one step kind of leads to the next step, it leads to the next step. And if we were going to model and demonstrate what a Rube Goldberg machine is, these are kind of those models, right? From a technical standpoint, they're kind of those models. So the first one in the junior division goes to Team Space Shark. So Team Space Shark, I didn't do the drum roll. I'm sorry. I forgot the drum roll. So Kathy is still looking things up, I know.
I am still looking. Sorry.
So while she's doing that, I will pull up the Team Space Shark video with the best technical drawing or best technical. I'm so used to saying technical drawing from our engineering competitions.
All right. So here we go. Are we going to? These are the
Team Space Shark.
Team Space Shark.
Greetings. This is our Minecraft Rube Goldberg machine.
All right. We're going to kill the audio on this just a little bit, but we want to just share the visual, because again, as we can see, it's going through every step. And one of the things this team did, if we were to let the video play out in its entirety, is they really, really clearly talked and explained how every step led to the next step, led to the next step, led to the next step. But, you know, I don't even think we need the explanation, because we can see it in action, and they made a clear, concise video. They clearly labeled their steps. The machine parts are obvious. The simple machines where they are obvious. And they just technically brought it all together really well. And they had a cute little theme, too. They had this kind of pirate adventure theme in the background going on in the waterways, which was a clever way to do it.
And it's very beautiful to look at. I mean, it really was sometimes like having space between the elements allows those transfers of energy to breathe in a way that's very visual and that we actually acknowledge when we're seeing live machine builds as well as digital ones.
Absolutely. Yeah. And this is, you know, this is the model I would hold up if I was showing teams, what is it we want to see? How should your camera work be? You know, because again, there's never a point where I don't know where we're supposed to be looking, right? Mm-hmm. I can clearly see every step. The video is clear and concise. It's technically, this is an achievement, right? It's perfect from every technical aspect of our rubric.
This looks so fun. I want to be in the machine myself, riding along. This is great.
I know, right? And it's funny because we get a lot of those, you know, there's sometimes a confusion between maybe a roller coaster and a Rube Goldberg machine. And one of the things we always try to clarify is that a roller coaster can be part of a Rube Goldberg machine, but a Rube Goldberg machine is not a roller coaster, right? Mm-hmm. There's more to it than that.
It's the same thing about domino runs, because a lot of the people in our world who build Rube Goldberg machines for us, for advertisers, and for themselves are part of this show called Domino Masters, which is on TV now. And I often say a domino run is not a Rube Goldberg machine. A domino run can be part of a Rube Goldberg machine, especially when it's made from something else that is not actually a domino. So you see books, and we're going to see that in a build that is coming up. We have seen containers. We've seen CDs and albums used in domino runs or pieces of bread. So, you know, that's always kind of
yeah. And again, there's a lot of elements in this that are using the mine carts and kind of have roller coaster elements, but there's always something bridging the steps in between, right? We see boats shooting across. We see armor stands on ice sliding around. We see slime blocks bouncing things up in the air.
Right.
We saw the arrow and target blocks.
Transfers of energy.
Yeah.
That makes the difference. That makes it more than just a roller coaster.
Exactly. You know, I feel like if
it's I'm not lost, right? I mean, sometimes I watch one and I'm like, where? It's like watching lacrosse, kind of. Where's the ball?
Right. But yeah, I mean, I think they did a phenomenal job, right? And again, we're seeing all of those elements. There's a snowball. I mean, this is actually the first time I've seen a snowball used in one of the machines, so it's really great. I love it. But again, if it's a true Rube Goldberg machine, I don't know that you could ride it in its entirety without something horrible happening, because there's always something chaotic taking place. Like right there, a bunch of pirates were just blown up by TNT, right? You don't want to be, I don't know that you want to be on that ride.
I might have just changed my mind.
Great about this one is that it was lit up for the whole thing until just now. Like there were quite a few that were dark because the task was to light up the book. So then the whole world was dark and it was hard to see what was happening until the very end, that final piece, right? That one was great.
They kind of used daylight and the time clock to really make that part of the impact of their machine.
Right, yeah. And so that one again was getting an award for being one of the best technical submissions that we got.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So congratulations to that team. That was Team Space Shark.
Space Shark.
Yay, woo-woo.
So Kathy, have we ascertained?
Yes, I have. Mm-hmm. So, that first team, Crazy Aliens, they are from Miami-Dade.
Wow.
Great. My neck of the woods.
Mm-hmm.
Well, south of me, but still my neck of the woods.
South of you.
And the second team that we just saw?
Second team.
Oh, well, now you gave her more homework to do.
Yeah, well, I'm going to ask this question after each one.
I know. Right. Go ahead. You should ask. You should definitely. That was the, wait, tell me.
Shark. That was Space Team Shark. Space Shark. Team Space Shark.
Team Space Shark.
Yeah, and while you're looking
watching
that one up,
this right now, and they're yelling, we're from here.
That's right. And so while you're looking that up, we're going to pull up the next technical challenge winner. So they were a technical challenge winner from the junior division. We have a technical challenge, or best technical from the senior division. And that is, I guess we'll do the little drum roll. Oh. Everyone wants to get involved in the drum roll. It keeps us active. Team Izzy and the Marionettes. So Izzy and the Marionettes, and we've got their video queued up. And again, we'll keep the audio off so we can talk a little bit about the technicality of their video. I did love the little intro and card, but they do a phenomenal job of walking through the challenge and really doing a good job explaining it. Let's see if we can jump ahead a little bit to the actual run of the machine. There we go. But same thing, right? So they had a really great theme where it goes from biome to biome, but again, the transfers in energy that they've created, right? Again, not just a roller coaster. But clearly a Rube Goldberg machine with a variety of elements, with a variety of things taking place. Again, great camera work so we can see what's happening, each step of what's happening, even knowing when to pause kind of the camera because they know the next step's going to be right here, so let's wait the camera right there. That camera work is so important. Like, I know that was Kathy's stressor. Cannot stress it enough. Because it lets us see what's really going on. And it is always
a challenge when filming a Rube Goldberg machine.
It is
challenging. And the fact that you guys have done such a great job, because it helps us follow, you know, what we're watching.
You know, I always wonder, like, as Rube Goldberg machines get bigger, more complex, and get outdoor, and that technology gets bigger, like, right, we're seeing this cool, in Minecraft world, this aerial view of this, which is probably something that wasn't too possible before. But now with drones, you're probably getting really cool camera work, even in the real ones. Mm-hmm.
You know what? The coolest thing that happened was the GoPro. You were in the machine.
Oh, yeah.
They put that in, let's say, a little truck that is part of the transfers of energy, and if you had several, you could go from one camera to the next. So
And even right there were like five really fast transfers of energy, and they kept the camera, admittedly it panned quickly, but they kept it where we could still see every step that was taking place in between.
It's also graphically very beautiful to watch again. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, their theming was beautiful. They went with a theme of going through the various unnatural biomes of the Minecraft world. So they didn't want to use the natural ones. They didn't go with the forest or the ice plains. No, they went with the Nether. They went with the Mushroom Islands. So they went with the weird ones. We like weird.
And I love weird. I'm all about weird.
Oh, yep. Here we go.
So, they used the in-game book, but they did this really cool redstone light up sign to make you really know there's a book going on.
Well, Izzy, Ren, Callum, Axel, bravo to you guys.
Yes, indeed. Great job. Right. Congratulations.
So, Space Sharks.
Space Sharks.
They are also from Miami-Dade.
Wow.
Oh, Miami-Dade is rolling right now.
Wow.
Okay. And then do you want to take a guess on Izzy and the Marionettes?
I was trying to place the accent.
Oh, they are not from Miami-Dade. I led you down the path and you went. And
I followed you.
Did the bait. So Izzy and the Marionettes, they are from the UK. They're from Windsor, England.
Wow.
Somewhere.
Mm-hmm. I hate to say it. I could see how the coloration and the kind of design elements speak of a sort of European sensibility.
Wow.
How nice.
Fantastic.
Well, that's bravo awesome. To you guys.
Well, congratulations. So those three teams received the awards that were basically you inspired us to say we want to recognize their technical abilities and the fact that there was such a great final step here. So congratulations to the three teams there. And yes. And now we're going to move on to the at-home division. So that was open to all ages. And let's see here. We have one award in this division. Eric or Kathy, do you want to introduce this team?
Kathy hasn't introduced one yet. I don't know if she's busy. She's been busy looking up where they're from.
She's been looking up where they're from.
I'm making sure that I...
All right, I'll say it and you can look it up. So for our at-home division winner, our winner is, and I love this name, so Team Zombie Apocalypse.
Oh, awesome.
And for the record, when you see their video and their theme, you're going to go, oh yeah, Team Zombie Apocalypse.
So, I was hoping it was going to be related. This is going to be fun. Here we go.
That's it.
This is my Rube Goldberg project. The theme is zombies.
Uh-huh.
This project starts out from this button, which activates these minecarts to develop. This goes across the track to this intersection, goes up this inclined plane, no pun intended, and then it goes across this broken bridge. It will drop down to hit this lever, which will go down, throw a zombie across this like ice rink. It will hit that pressure plate, go up this second inclined plate, hit the cactus, create this huge domino, which is an effect. Create this zombie to attack a villager, which will go up this elevator, hit that pressure plate to throw an object down this screw. After going through the screw, it will go on top of this pressure plate, which will activate these things in the hopper to go up this pulley, which will go down. Hit the pressure plate, go up these. This will move to here, and it will shoot arrows to that target, and another minecart will go around this loop. Here's and we'll go second. Minecart will bounce. It will go here, bounce up, go down through this hole of the zombie, then go down through here, and it will turn on this generator, or maybe an axle, which will turn on this flying machine, and it will go across. The zombie goes through the water, which will activate a redstone output to make a minecart go across here. After going through here, go through the building, put a zombie on it, and open the book. This is the run through of my bubble machine.
Again, such a good job with all the simple machines. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you what's hard to do too, is sticking on a particular theme. So, and making sure that most of the elements kind of partake, you know, have something to do with that theme. And that's something they did a really good job of. Even as they were describing it, kind of everything was zombie related in some form or another. And I love the way the book shows up at the end. They did a really good job with that. But I don't want to give it away, so I'm not going to give away the secrets yet. I find myself just staring at these things. Like
they're mesmerizing.
They really are.
Well, because it's both. You're watching it work, but then I'm thinking, how did they make that work? How did they do that? Very cool.
I don't know how coding works specifically, but I would imagine that this is sort of a visual representation.
So it's interesting. So they did most of theirs with redstone, right? In fact, most of what we're seeing here is utilizing redstone. And what's great about redstone is you're still using a lot of the logic that you would use in coding. You're creating logic gates. You're creating circuitry that are making all these things happen. And you have to consider all the things like the timing of those activities and elements and so on as they go. And they did a great job of it.
Oh, and they did a great job too with the day-to-night.
Yeah.
Yeah, the day-to-night. Fireworks, and there it glows, and the dark.
And it's the zombie reading the book.
Right.
And every zombie needs a good book, I mean.
Absolutely.
Oh, that was great. Awesome. All right, and so that was team, well, we have said it, zombie apocalypse.
Zombie
congratulations.
Apocalypse.
Well, where are they from?
They are from New Jersey.
New Jersey. All right. Fun to see these winners from different places. That's great.
I love it.
All right. So next we're going to move on to the junior division. So this was ages 11 to 14. And we will start with third place. And the third place winners are...
I love their name because they're not the Backstreet Boys. They are the Front Street Boys.
I love that. All right, let's take a look at what the Team Front Street Boys created.
On a rock, flying for space at 67,000 miles per hour, Homo sapiens started a race to reach the great beyond. Wonder is even better than ones here. So, here at Team Front Street Boys, this is Joseph.
This is Lucas.
And we'll be here to show you the space race machine.
Our teammates Ben and Hudson are not here today.
So here we go down, of course, the Sputnik 1. First object to ever enter space.
Minecart rolls down an inclined plane, hits another minecart on the turn. These are the first three animals in space, a monkey, a cat, and a dog.
But the dog was the first one, though.
Here is Yuri Gagarin, the first man in space. Here he is orbiting the Earth. Now we go to the first man on the moon, which was Neil Armstrong. The minecart rolls down another inclined plane.
And goes right into the NASA headquarters, where they found out that Mars usually have an atmosphere.
Here you have Mr. Elon Musk with his loads of billions of dollars. Which the minecart rolls up a lever.
Oh, I love it. I'm sorry.
That is one of my favorite moments.
Down the lever.
Fantastic. If you wanted to know actually how much he spent on this SpaceX, it was $1.8 billion.
Minecart. So here's a pulley. Minecart goes up the pulley. Sheep goes down the pulley.
Such a good representation of a pulley there.
Pushes another minecart on top of the pulley and now goes up the screw, which is holding the huge SpaceX rocket.
I love the theme within the theme.
So here, during this, we'll show you a fact about the second man to be on the moon, Buzz Aldrin.
You know, Jen, you had mentioned in one of our streams talking about like those moments that go slow and build tension. Right? And even the kids pointed out that patience is key, right? We're slowly waiting for this to happen.
And we would be rich if... No.
Finally, at the top of the screw, the minecart goes through the SpaceX rocket, hits a command block, which will spawn things. And the UFO comes to abduct the top part of the book, which opens the book, and we used light blocks to illuminate the book.
Well, it's not really exactly opening, more than ripping off the book's face.
Let's see if you remember. Bonus question. Who was the second man on the moon?
If you guess it was Buzz Aldrin, you got it.
Oh, that's great.
You know, we talked about like doing a book, and they're one of the only entries we had that did nonfiction. Not only did they do nonfiction, they clearly wanted to educate about the topic, right? They kept throwing mm-hmm. in little facts along the way. And even when we were forced to watch that slow elevation of the screw climbing all the way up inside the SpaceX rocket or the launch pad of the SpaceX rocket, they were like, okay, well, we'll fill this with some science facts. So it's time for some science
right.
facts.
Right, exactly.
Joseph, Ben, Lucas, and Hudson, we loved it.
That was fantastic. It. Good job, Front Street Boys.
We have the narrative, their theme, really went from the very beginning to the very end in super visual, concrete ways, from, you know, teaching us about space exploration to Elon Musk to entering mm-hmm. NASA. I mean, it was really of a whole. It was very together. Loved it.
Right. That was great. And mm-hmm. Kathy, where were the team Front Street Boys from?
The Front Street Boys were from Miami-Dade.
Wow. All right.
Miami coming on strong.
Miami-Dade.
Yeah, coming in very strong.
Yes. Very impressive. All right. So second place in the junior division. So again, this is ages 11 to 14. And the winners are...
This one goes to Team Mask of Darkness. And I'm not going to tell you what their theme was because it will be blaringly obvious.
All right, here we go.
Welcome to the Harry Potter Rube Goldberg Machine. Today, I'll take you through the whole wizarding world of Harry Potter. We're going to start at the 9 3/4 platform, and we're going to press the button. Oh, look, a minecart. It's releasing fireworks into the air. Now starting a domino chain. It's dropping four banners, which are revealing all four houses. Then the ball falls. This is starting a marble race through all the Quidditch letters. What's going to happen here? It looks like a ball is going to go through two hoops. One and two. Looks like it's lighting up a path to this chessboard. What's going to happen? Oh, the pieces are moving. Now it's time for the big arrival of all three main Harry Potter characters. Harry Potter, Hermione, and Ron. Now we go to the snake from the Chamber of Secrets with a minecart that's slithering around the snake's body. I wonder what's going to happen when the minecart gets to the end.
It really does look like it's slithering.
Oh no,
right?
The snake, it's dead. Oh look, a block is levitating up to the top. That's going to trigger some water to fall down this giant Harry Potter wall. When the water reaches the bottom, it'll trigger a light path to reach the final book. Oh wow, the book is opened up to reveal the end of Harry Potter.
Love it.
Oh, that is great. I love it.
I love that one.
Yeah, so good. And again, you know, the little narrative things, right? Like clearly, mm-hmm. you know, obviously understanding the story, having a really obvious and very clear theme, right? We didn't have to guess what the theme was. All of the elements of the build had to do with that theme. And I'll tell you kind of a behind the scenes secret. So every team has to submit two video runs of their build. And we got two from this team. And in the first run that they submitted, it got all the way to the end. And then the book didn't quite function the way they wanted. And you even heard one of the team members, or maybe it was a teacher, ever go, did the book work? And it was like, no, it didn't quite work that time. And then they submitted it the second time and it worked perfectly. So a little perseverance in there because they made it work beautifully. Mm. I love that that was in there because I got to see sort of like, you know, the how the sausage was made. I got to see behind the scenes a little bit and go, oh yeah, they fixed that. They did a good job.
Could we say possibly that there was an iteration that happened?
Yes.
From the first one to the next one?
Yes.
Right? You learn it.
Well, and it might
again.
Not even just be one iteration. It might be more than one. I mean, I had a student create a Rube Goldberg last year, and I just remember, well, he was great kid, but he had, you know, we gave him some feedback, and he came back, and he said, in the recording, I think, well, here's my revised Rube Goldberg, and I may have cried more than 50 times while doing this.
Well, that's iteration.
Yeah.
Right. Yes, exactly.
But right. So if that helps, if that's the strategy that helps, which is do it and cry and do it and cry and do it and cry until you do it and don't cry. then mission accomplished.
I guess. I don't know. That sounds a little harsh.
Thematically, when we chose the task to open a book, one of the themes that we really were convinced that we would see entries using was Harry Potter. So I'm really excited that they chose that for their theme and they used it so well.
They really did.
They did a great job. So that was.
Would you say that it was magical?
Yes. So that was Team Mask of Darkness. And Kathy, where were they from?
Okay, I'm waiting for confirmation, but I believe they're from Greensboro, North Carolina.
Wow. Okay. Very.
Oh, now
cool.
I have to head north. Okay.
All right.
I'm sandwiched in between all these amazing Minecraft builders.
All right. I'm out here on the West Coast waiting for something from my region to show up. So I'm
no. It's all the talent is down here in the Southeast, clearly, or at least on the East side. Okay, so we have New Jersey too, and then you can keep going way east across the ocean. And
Right.
So we are ready for first place in the junior division. We are ready for first place in the junior division, and I'm sure everyone who's watching is super excited and wants us to do the drum roll and wants me to say it already, but I'm not going to say it because I don't want to.
Say it already.
All right, I'll say it already. Okay. It is Team, and I like the name, Cube Goldbergers.
I love
the Team
that.
Cube
That's
Goldbergers.
So
right? And it makes sense, the Cube Goldbergers. Like, if you're going to do Minecraft and Rube Goldberg, you get Cube Goldberg. So the Cube Goldbergers... and we're going to go ahead and play their submission.
If I could rename it, I would rename it right now to the Cube Goldberg.
The whole competition to the Cube Goldberg competition. It's brilliant, right? We may have to ask them for the rights. Yeah, we'll see.
Right. We have the trademark rights. All right, here we go. Let's watch their submission.
Ah!
I was in France and
exactly
the back back part of the kitchen looking for the cookbook.
Exactly.
You know, one of the great things.
We talked about cookbooks too, and we said, "I wonder what kind of books people are going to come up with." We knew there'd be at least one kitchen in a cookbook.
You know, one of the great things about that one is, we talk about narrative, how important it is to have narrative. And it's that reminder that narrative doesn't always need words. There was like a clear narrative there, right? We started with a chef looking for his cookbook. We went on this adventure through the whole house looking for it, right? We went through like the baby room and and through like the bedroom or wherever. And we went through the bathroom, like literally in the shower and the bathtub, and then back into the kitchen until we found the cookbook, right? So we knew what the narrative was the whole time without a single word really being spoken.
Mm-hmm. And the music also kind of reinforced like location, attitude. And like you said, there were no words spoken, but boy, did it send the narrative home.
Right. Yeah. So congratulations, Team Cube Goldbergers. That was fantastic. And that is our first place entry in the junior division. So we're so proud of you and of everyone who entered in that division. Really great work.
Phenomenal. Yeah. And that takes us to...
Wait, Kathy, where are they from?
Not yet.
Yeah, Kathy.
Waiting on confirmation. Waiting on confirmation.
We don't know.
Can't quite tell, right?
I love that we have our own team PI investigating the location of each team as they come up, right? Like, Kathy is on it.
This information in real time.
That's right.
Exactly. And we'll make sure that we post, by the way, when this is over, we're going to put a post on the NASEP website with all the locations. So,
okay. Ready?
Yes.
So Cube. Okay. So I can confirm that Mask of Darkness is from North Carolina. And guess what, Claire, you will be very happy to hear the Cube Goldbergers are from San Diego.
Woohoo! Let's go, California. Yes. I thought we were going to get skunked. I was worried there. Awesome. That's great.
Well, and I just want to mention too, before we go to the next division, I liked that, you know, there was one point where they showed water, represented water, and they did not use water. They used glass blocks.
They did.
For that.
So they either clone command or used, to do a lot of that, which is really phenomenal and not easy.
Great.
All right. So we're ready. Are we ready for senior division? This is our ages 14 to 18 year old division. And we have our three winners, starting with third place. We have, what do we have? Such an appropriate one for Minecraft team. We have a drum roll. We have Team TNT Clan.
All right.
We have a machine you to take a look at. We work hard for. Hope you like it.
The world of the enchanted forest. The magical things, people, and, you know, animals. Books and quills and everything else they can find in this world. It's magical. While I'm talking, you can see the bird view of the world. Hope you like it. Enjoy! Whoa, I hate going through portals. Oh look, it's a mineshaft. Gem farm, that's interesting. What's that? Let me take a look at that. I mean, they changed colors. That's kind of boring. Nothing in the barrels I can loot? What do you mean? I don't steal stuff.
Okay, this is the machine. I just fixed it. You want to use it?
I will be happy to.
Okay, it's going to be 30 coins though.
Oh, nice. I think I have just enough.
Thank you. Let's start the machine.
Minecart goes up slope. It drops down into the lever. The wolf going down the incline plane. Going up into the pulley. Getting pushed in. Forward on a slam block, jumps two times, and dies. No real wolves will harm the man. Michael goes up into the implant plane and goes through the sticky, 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 slimy honey. It's really nasty sounds. The redstone is really good. Brum, brum. The minecart with the chest on it falls down into the giant iceberg.
go through. It's gonna take a while. We gotta take where. Boop, boop, boop. How was your day? The weather was nice. Oh, it's here. Okay. It finally drops into the pressure plate. Don't start so early. The book opens and we enchant it. So it's gonna light it up. Everything lights up. Anyways. Yeah, that's so cool. It's beautiful and magical. Thank you for watching, I guess.
Thank you so much for doing watching and reviewing our machine. That was so
cool. This is Team TNT, and thank you for watching our machine.
Woohoo! So sick, so epic, yeah. Thank you so much. I mean, yeah, I think I'm cool.
Oh, wow. I loved the narration. That was so fun.
You know, it's yeah, we ask for humor, and admittedly, not every machine can be hilarious, but you know what? The narrative can sometimes be hilarious, and sometimes we've just got students who are clearly the class clowns a bit, but in the best possible way.
Absolutely.
It was magical. I mean, it really, it visually, it was pretty incredible to watch.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I like that they had this kind of symmetrical three, you know, circular design of the whole world with the pillars around. Like, I like when you've got a theme that's like all encompassing, that there is like, it's like world building, right? In any narrative, like you've got a world and I can see the whole world of it. You know, that's something I always love. Same with the one we just watched before that, right? You could see the whole house. Like, I could clearly see the setting, right? Because setting is a really important part of narrative. And they did that as well.
They sure did. So yeah. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Team TNT Clan. And Kathy, they are from?
Oh boy, you're not going to be surprised. Miami-Dade.
Oh, woohoo. Congratulations.
Wow, they are really at the top of the heap.
They are.
We'll see if their name comes up again.
Miami-Dade.
That's right. All right, we are moving up. This is now going to be our second place winner in the senior division, ages 14 to 18. And
all right, and our second place winner, drum roll, is team, and I hope I pronounce it correctly, Gornail Gamers 2.0. So not 1.0, iteration 2.0.
Right, iteration.
They are taking a trip to the library.
Library is looking better than ever. And before I go through, I gotta give them my library pass just to let them know part of the library. So we go through and we start. Here we got a simple lever. Leads into a fight between the Vindicator and the Iron Golem, which leads to a sand drop. Turns on a generator, produces electricity in a path, goes over here and spawns a redstone block. That leads into an armor stand pulley, which then leads to the boat push. Boats are pushed onto a plate and it activates the next one. That is going to lead into a piston observer chain, which activates and leads into an AND gate, turning on a cobblestone generator, which turns on a campfire, leads to a sand launcher, along with a firework display, a few mine carts over here, which lead into more AND gates, turn on this flying machine. Here they go. This flying machine turns up that target block. Thankfully, the sand is just making it, and now the dispenser can fire upon the target block. Hits it perfectly. Goes the minecart, turns at night, hello. It goes the fireball, shoots the fire. The observer is going to see that. It's going to activate this congog. And it's going to activate this other observer chain, which activates the water, the lava activated earlier with the minecarts. And now they're going to join together. And join into a cobblestone generator. It's going to create cobblestone. Piston's going to push it out. And it's going to go all the way to this observer over here.
I loved this part, the idea of using the cobblestone generator, which is always a slow mechanism in Minecraft, but using it here, and especially the way the two water and lava spiral together. Mm-hmm. So clever.
I feel like every year we get elements that surprise even you guys, the experts.
Now it's going to activate the observer, launching an item.
Always something new, yeah.
Gold block goes down, goes here and over the plate, opens the door. Redstone block spawns, activates a gate, activates the light shell. Zombie goes over here, jumps on the plate for us, activates another flying machine, comes up here to a piston chain, then activates the spiral, activates the fire trails, then activates another minecart, call it the raceway. It keeps going around, and over time, pistons get closer and closer with the rails so it can activate the next part of the machine. This part of the machine is active. A water observer is here. Goes over to a bamboo observer, into another piston chain. Wirelessly transmits that it needs to activate this fuse. Uh-oh, fuse destroyed everything. Oh, but thankfully, everything landed safely. Leads into another chain, a door. Here goes the minecart on an inclined plane. Activates the piston. Let's see what happens. Secret door to a room with the book. The book opens up and it's lit up.
That was great.
That was excellent.
So, yeah, library. I thought we'd see more libraries now that I think about it.
No, great. And you know what? That was pretty much the only library build we had. You know, I was like, okay, well. Yeah. I definitely thought that would be a bigger part of themes, would be this idea of going to get a book from the library or something like that.
Well, in the
sure enough, we got one.
Right now, we're judging the live competition entries, which we're building these machines in the real world. We got library machines. We have zombie machines. We have Harry Potter machines. So we are right in the sweet spot with all of these.
Perfect. I'd love to see those kind of into a video side by side. You know, like here's a real world Harry Potter one. Here's a Minecraft Harry Potter one. Here's a real world library one. Here's a Minecraft library one.
Right,
yeah, it'd
exactly.
be fantastic to see. All right, well, it is time. What is it time for? Someone was drum rolling already.
Am I overly eager on the drum roll?
No, we can do that. We can start the drum roll, but. This is one I want to kind of hype up. So this is our first place winner in the senior division. This is our ultimate build. We have to go to Kathy though, don't we?
Yeah, we did not announce the name location of number two.
So we had the name. The name was the Gornell Gamers 2.0, but where are they from, Kathy?
Well, they are from, Eric, they're from Miami.
Do I get to guess?
Wait, I gave you the answer. They're
I was going to guess.
Not sure. Yeah, they're from Miami. I'm not sure if it's part of Miami-Dade.
So Miami-Dade is the county. Yeah.
Right. So they're in Miami. I don't know if it's part of the district, that school district, or if it's private school.
Awesome.
But also
from
Miami.
The location. But also from Miami,
Florida.
So we had a huge chunk of entries from Miami-Dade, more than from any other location. Yes. So, you know, it's one of those things where if you throw enough great stuff at us from one place, they're bound to take home several of the prizes. And sure enough, I think that's the case here.
Well, thank you, Miami-Dade.
Yeah, thanks. Big thanks to Miami-Dade. So now it's time. First place, senior division. And before we even drum roll, I want to hype this one up because I've never watched, like, we've watched ones that are incredible. We watched ones that have wowed us. I've never been completely floored by one until now. And not just because of the elements, but because of all of it. The theme, the narrative of it, even though there's not a single word really said in it. The use of music, and it syncs in theme with the music. The music is very much part of the overall theme. It's just like a total package. And I had to pick up my job off the floor after watching it and then watched it again.
Wait, was there Star Wars in there?
There was not Star Wars. You would think from my excitement there would be Star Wars, but there was no Star Wars.
The knife.
The chef. This is such an immersive entry. I mean, I really felt like I was in an incredible movie, an incredible video game. It had every aspect of just wow.
It really, really did. So with that in mind, I'm very, very proud and fortunate, and I feel humbled to announce this winner who has made me feel humbled as a Minecraft global mentor. And that is Team Double Triple Torque Cannon. Double Triple Torque Cannon. And we're going to check out their video. It's a work of art. So
awesome.
So let's check it out.
also suspenseful. You blew our minds.
That was amazing.
Completely.
That's amazing.
Unbelievable.
I don't even know what goes into syncing it with the music so perfectly. Also, like, how many attempts let's go back to iteration. How many tries does it take before you're like, there it is, it's perfect, it syncs up with the music, and then having to do the next step and having that sync up.
Right. That was fantastic. You know,
what they also illustrated beyond just the incredible facility and ability with Minecraft and visuals and narrative, but even music had a sort of chain reaction to it. So you started in silence, and then you built with some classical, and you ended up in this, like, you know, prog rock thing. And it just, there's a chain reaction to almost everything in our lives, you know? And boy, did they nail it. They really did.
Really did. So bravo again to Team Double Triple Torque Cannon. Where were they from, Kathy?
Well, Team Double Triple Torque Cannon, they were from New Jersey.
New Jersey.
Awesome.
We've gone full circle.
We have.
Oh, everybody, yeah. Everyone in the squares, we all were represented, all our regions.
Yep, that's right.
It's true. Well, we are just, this was such an exciting year. I hope that everyone who's watching got something from these amazing machines and learned something that they can take with them into their Minecraft journey. And that, you know, next year we're going to have a whole new challenge for you guys. So
I know. Can't wait to see what we cook up. It'll be fun for sure.
We'll figure that out then.
Absolutely. And also we want to mention, we do have a couple of other Minecraft events that NACEF is hosting that are still going on. So if you have been inspired, as we have by watching these videos, it's not too late for you to join in. We have both the Digital Junior Solar Sprint, which is presented in partnership with the Army Educational Outreach Program. And that involves building a solar vehicle in an amazing custom Minecraft world that our team at CleverLike has developed. That is option one. And then we also have NACEF FarmCraft going on. And that is a place, a special world, again, custom world, where you can develop agricultural skills and learn all about agriculture and the environment and climate change, but in the awesome and fun and creative world of Minecraft. So those are both open to you now, and you just go to nacef.org, and then under the compete menu, go all the way down to Minecraft events, and you will find those there. So,
and may
parting
I just,
words. Yes.
I just want to send a shout out to folks who love Rube Goldberg and the machines. There's still time. You can enter our crazy contraption cartoon contest at RubeGoldberg.com. So there's another way to win with your Rube Goldberg machine. Again, in this one, you get to choose the task or the problem that you solve. So if you want to feed your dog, or, you know, mow the lawn, or turn the lights out when you go to bed, it's up to you. And draw a machine for us and send it in. Again, there are prizes and bragging rights and all kinds of good stuff. So maybe we'll get to see you there.
That sounds awesome. Jennifer, at NACEF, we so much love and appreciate working with you and the whole team at the Rube Goldberg Institute. You all are phenomenal. We really appreciate this partnership and the chance to bring this amazing event to students and to see their creativity. I mean, obviously we all have been blown away by all the different aspects of what they've done, but thank you so much for joining with us. And we look forward to doing it again next year. So thanks everyone for joining us.
Thank you, Claire.
Thanks so much. And again,
thank you, Kathy.
Incredible work. Incredible work, students, everyone. Phenomenal job. And thank you, Jen. Thank you, Kathy. And Claire, you've become the most incredible host ever.
Yes.
So thank you, Claire.
I get to sit and look at, I get to watch all these videos. I just was blown away. I'll say I was noticing at one point, we all were just looking at the videos and watching what these kids have done. They're amazing. So
they're amazing.
Thank you, everyone. We'll see you next time.